Hello everyone, welcome to Semicon Talk. Today, I'd like to talk about wafer backgrinding process. This is the first step of semiconductor packaging process. Before we talk about this, let's think a little bit about wafer first, which is used in wafer backgrinding process. Semiconductor wafer is a thin, circle-shaped plate typically made of silicon and has integrated circuit on top. But on backside, there is no integrated circuit, so it looks like dull gray color with nothing. There are many different diameters, mostly 300mm and 200mm. Most frequently asked question is, why silicon wafer is circle shape rather than square or rectangle? The answer is, circle shape is the best way to make very pure silicon. Pure means no other material rather than silicon. And semiconductor need very pure silicon because it need to control electrical signal very, very precisely. If there is other material, it makes impossible to control electrical signal very precisely. If so, why circle-shaped silicon is pure? Because manufacturing process of very pure silicon wafer looks like this, and it is cut as wafers. There are other shapes of silicon wafer like this, but these are not pure like circle shape. And usually, it is for a solar panel to generate electricity. The other question is, why we use silicon for semiconductor? The answer is, silicon has very good electrical and mechanical properties for semiconductor. And it is the most abundant element of Earth's crust, means not expensive. Let's get back to today's topic, wafer backgrinding. It is also called as wafer thinning or wafer lapping. What is wafer backgrinding? It is the process to reduce wafer thickness from backside. Why we need to reduce wafer thickness? Wafer thickness determines package height, and if we use thin wafer, we can reduce package height. Because package with reduced height is perfect to be used in slim electronic product like smartphone. That is the reason we need wafer backgrinding process. Typically, wafer is 300mm diameters with 775 micrometer thickness and weighs 125 gram before wafer backgrinding. The final wafer thickness after wafer backgrinding is different by devices. Logic device which has very complex circuit inside is grinded to about 100 micrometers. DRAM memory device to around 50 micrometers. And NAND memory device down to around 30 micrometers. Let's look at the process more detail. First, wafer is placed on rotary table in the wafer backgrinding machine. This time, wafer backside faces upward to grinding wheel. First step is grinding. In this step, grinding wheel at top is rotating and used to grind backside of silicon wafer. During this grinding process, most target amount of silicon wafer is removed. But this process is kind of rough grinding, so wafer surface has mechanical damage. Second step is polishing. In this step, polishing wheel at top is rotating and used to polish backside of silicon wafer and remove damaged part. Then finally, we'll get thinned wafer. By the way, actual wafer backgrinding process is much more complex, but this will be a good introduction to understand this process. I hope you enjoy this episode. Have a nice day and see you again soon. Bye bye.